Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October 9th of 2021, well, it is titled 50 light years to 51 Pegasi. So what do we see here? Well, we see an observatory in the foreground, and then looking up, we can see the constellation of Pegasus, the great square of Pegasus representing the body of the winged horse, partially blocked out by the telescope dome. And we can actually see Andromeda, which borders Pegasus and actually shares one star with it, that bright star right at the junction of the two. And we can also see labeled up above Andromeda is M31. That is the Andromeda galaxy, the nearest large spiral galaxy to our own. Now, just above the dome, we see 51 Pegasi. And this is a star, and actually a relatively famous star now. And it was 26 years ago, back in 1995, that astronomers discovered a planet orbiting 51 Pegasi. So it's hard to think we hear about all of the discoveries of planets outside our solar system. This was the first discovery of a planet orbiting a sun-like star. Previous discoveries had found planets orbiting very compact stars, remnants of a supernova explosion, but this was the first time we had detected planets orbiting a star, ordinary star, much like our own sun. How did they find this out? Well, looking at the star and watching its motion. So when planet orbits around a star, it tugs on it and causes its velocity to change. Sometimes the planet will pull it in the opposite direction. The planet will be moving away from us, so the star will be moving towards us. And other times the planet will be moving towards us and the star will be moving away. We can measure those changes in velocity through what is called the Doppler shift. And it was found that this was a planet that had roughly the mass of Jupiter, about half of Jupiter's mass, and orbited in just a little over 4 days. Now, if we think about that, that is a very unusual thing. And this is what we call a hot Jupiter now. Hot Jupiters are planets that are similar in size to Jupiter, but orbit very close to their stars. Now, if it orbits within 4 days, Mercury in our solar system, the innermost planet, takes 88 days to orbit around our sun. So this planet is extremely close to the star. Now, that helps us in making it very easy to detect, because we see the variations very quickly over just a few days, rather than having to wait years if you were trying to detect Mercury around a distant star. But it also makes us question some of our ideas of planetary formation. And how do these stars form? Because our current models of planetary formation would have said that you wouldn't form such large planets close to a star. So the discovery of now 4,000, more than 4,000 exoplanets have us giving us much more data and allowing us to better reconsider and understand how planets form. And this one here, 51 Pegasi B, it's the planet's name, also now named Dimidium for half. And it was actually the first planet around a sun-like star to be discovered in October of 1995. So that was our picture of the day for October 9th of 2021. It was titled 50 light years to 51 Pegasi. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be full moon silhouettes. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.